particularly young people, are very much versed in communicating science or things, actually everything, in short sentences and brief messages and in teasers and these kind of things. And I don't know how you feel about it, but if you try to make a teaser or a short message on a scientific level that is correct, you have to give it some thought. So, and that's what I would like people to do. Well, I really hope that next year we have a full complement again, so 12. Mm-hmm. And we are looking for people from all kinds of disciplines and all different countries of the world who are studying in Europe and who are studying some science in Europe. So we want people from a scientific background who have the urge in them to communicate science to others and who would be thinking about an idea of maybe making this their main, you know, the kind of main profession. And if there are some among the younger people who are coming closer to the end of their studies maybe, or even some PhD students, who are thinking about maybe making it a new career or making a jab at it and see if it would work, I encourage them to apply. The call will be out somewhere in May, probably next year, for the Skopentag in Prague. And we are thinking of maybe getting a mix, some kind of, you know, people who are doing more online stuff remotely and some who are actually there. We have to see how that works. I think mainly it is the wish to communicate science in a scientific way to people who are not scientists. Yeah. Because one of the problems in communicating science is often that people oversimplify scientific facts, and that leads them to wrong facts. And then science gets annoyed, and it's always better to have science on your side, yeah, and make sure that science is communicated as it should be. And that doesn't mean that it has to be complicated, it just has to be correct. And I think scientists know best what is correct and what is not correct, and therefore scientists should be actually doing science communication. You're welcome.